Welcome to the video of electronic circuit. Electronic gadgets have become a vital part of our lives. They have made our lives more easy and convenient. Most gadgets have tiny electronic circuits that can control machines and process information. So we can say that electronic circuits are the life of many electrical appliances. In this video, we will go through an overview of electronic circuits. What are electronic circuits? In simple words, we can say that it is a connection of various electrical and electronic components using connecting wires on a breadboard or by soldering on PCB to form circuits, which are termed as electrical and electronic circuits. This is used to perform some useful functions like data transfer, signal amplification, and computation. Electric current is the flow of electric charge, while electric circuit is the conductive path for the flow of current. In circuits, a conductive wire is used to provide a connection between the voltage source and the load. So when can we call a circuit as electronic circuit? A circuit consisting of specific electronic components such as resistor, transistor, diodes, capacitor, etc. are connected by conductive wires through which electric current can flow. This is called as an electronic circuit. The circuit should provide a path for the current to flow. We can say that a circuit must form a loop. Or to be a circuit, this path must start and end at the same point. Both the electronic circuit and the electric circuit have the same definition. But the electronic circuit tends to be low voltage circuits. A circuit can be called as electronic circuit only if it has at least one active component. An electronic circuit contains many types of components which are divided into two types. Active components like transistor, diode, ICs, etc. and passive components like capacitor, resistor, inductor, etc. The following things are taken into consideration while designing an electronic circuit. Basic electronic components like capacitor, resistor, diodes, transistors. Then in power source, signal generator, DC power supplies. In measurement and analysis instruments, CRO and multimeter, etc. are considered. For example, this figure shows a simple circuit consisting of two components, a battery and a lamp. The circuit allows the current to flow from the battery to the lamp and through the lamp and then back to the battery. Thus, the circuit forms a complete loop. Circuits can be simple or complex. The simpler circuits have three basic elements: voltage source, load, and the conductive path. Voltage source is a two-terminal device like a battery or power system that provides a voltage in the circuit that causes the current to flow. Load. It is an element in the circuit that consumes power to perform a particular function. The load can be a simple bulb or a combination of components. Conductive path provides a way through which the current flows. The path starts from the voltage source, travel through the load, and then returns to the voltage source. This path must form a loop from the negative side of the voltage source to the positive side of the voltage source. Let us now look into some of the concept of the electronic circuit. Closed circuit. When a circuit is complete and forms a loop that allows the current to flow through, then the circuit is said to be closed circuit. Open circuit. When there is a fault in the electric wire or the electric component in a circuit or the switch is off, then it is called as open circuit. In the figure, it is shown that the bulb is not glowing either because the switch is off or there is a fault in the electric wire. In short circuit, when both points, that is the positive and the negative of the voltage source in a circuit, get joined with each other for some reason, then it is called as short circuit. The maximum current starts to flow under this situation. In a short circuit, the current flows at dangerously high levels. Electronic components get damaged if short circuit happens, cause a battery to explode, or maybe start a fire. Series and parallel circuit. When two or more loads are connected in a series, then it is called as series circuit. And when two or more loads are connected in parallel, then it is called as parallel circuit. From the given figure, in the series circuit, if one bulb gets fused, then the rest of the bulbs will not get power supply and will not glow. While in parallel circuit, if one bulb gets fused, then the rest of the bulbs will still get power supply and will glow. Now let's move on to the types of electronic circuit. A circuit can be classified into different types: analog electronic circuit, digital electronic circuit, and mixed signal circuit. Analog electronic circuit. The circuit in which the signals may vary continuously with time to corresponding to information being represented. The working of analog circuit can be done with a normal waveform, and the analog circuits can directly give the signal as the output. Example, voltage amplifier, power amplifier, etc. Digital electronic circuit is a circuit where the signal is either of two discrete levels, on off or true or false. Transistors are used to create logic gate to perform Boolean logic. A digital circuit alters the waveforms into pulse signals, and it has to change the information back to an analog signal to produce the output. Some of the examples are multiplex, demultiplex, encoder, decoder, etc. The mixed signal circuit contains elements and properties of both analog circuit and digital circuit, and hence it is also called as hybrid circuit. Example, timer, analog to digital converter, digital to analog converters. I hope that you have got a better understanding of this concept. Thank you for watching the video. For more details, please visit our website or mail to us.